Very pleasant good evening to all. So myself is Dr. Shiva Kumar, consultant pulmonologist, Dr. Kamakshi Memorial Hospital, Pallikar, Chennai. Now we are going to discuss something about the post-COVID sequelae. What exactly is the post-COVID sequelae? In simple terms, it is the late effect of COVID infection. For example, if a person got infected 3 months back and he has been completely recovered, and now he has presented with symptoms like tiredness, dry cough, chest tightness, wheezing, difficulty in breathing, all this will be called as post-COVID sequelae. So this can also be due to so many factors, but we can certainly say that there are so many evidences to say that this infection, being a very new one, we don't know about the long-term impacts of this virus, and so many studies are being on the way to know about the long-term impacts of this viral infection and from those who got recovered from it. So this post-COVID sequelae can be differentiated into two categories. It can be for those patients who got recovered or who got discharged, and second one will be for those patients who has been in hospital for a long period of time and whose status has been turned into COVID negative. I mean, whose swab status, microbiological status has been turned into negative, and they will remain in the hospital because of the sequelae of this infection, like a post-COVID pulmonary fibrosis, or it can be the pulmonary embolism and those things. Now, symptoms. The symptoms that can happen with this post-COVID sequelae can be differentiated into two: pulmonary symptoms and the symptoms of the rest of the systems. In terms of lungs, it can be, as I already told you, it can be the tiredness, dry cough, wheezing, difficulty in breathing, or the chest tightness. Sometimes he or she may tell you that the work which they have done before COVID, they couldn't be able to do it now. For example, it can be the jogging or it can be the running. So they will say these symptoms can be due to this post-COVID status. So we have to evaluate them for that. And second set is the extra pulmonary symptoms. So it can affect all the organs from the head to the toe. If it is a CNS, it can lead to the Guillain-Barré syndrome. Very few reports has been reported. Very few cases has been reported with respect to the GBS, and it can report a stroke. From the heart, it can be the dysfunction of the heart muscles, and it can be the skin. If it involved, it can be skin rashes, loss of hair, arthralgia. So it won't leave any system. It can affect from head to toe, and these sequelae should also be considered in mind when we see a patient. What are all the different types of sequelae that can happen? As we all know, the sequelae are directly proportional to the severity of the infection he or she had at that time. If a person had a mild to moderate disease, say lung involvement is only less than 50% when he or she had an infection, then the sequelae can range from bronchitis, bronchiolitis, bronchiolitis obliterans organizing pneumonia, or it can be the obstructive airway disease components. If the person had a severe involvement of the lung during the time of infection, we can able to say it can be above 50% of the lung involvement at that time, then now that patient may have a severe respiratory muscle dysfunction due to the long hospital stay, due to the NIV which they may have been for a long period of time, non-invasive ventilation, or it can also be due to the intubation and those things. So it can be the respiratory muscle dysfunction resulting in a type 2 respiratory failure, or it can be the post-COVID pulmonary fibrosis. These two are the dreadful sequelae which we will worry a lot. And one more thing is, there can be a blood vessel clots which can happen due to this post-COVID sequelae, yeah, because of the immune dysregulation and also because of the hematological dysregulation that is happening. We may have the blood clots within the pulmonary vessels, we can have it within the cerebral vessels, even the renal hypoxia has been documented. So these are all the dreadful sequelae which we have to keep in mind.